Winter of Our Discontents, page 131. When she was gone, I sprawled out in my chair, and I heard in my secret ears, "Lord, now let us though thy seventh depart in peace, according to thy word." And then if I didn't go to sleep, drop off a cliff into the dark right there in the living room. I don't do that often. And because I had been thinking of Danny Taylor, I dreamed of Danny Taylor. We were not small, great, but grown. We were at the flat, dry lake bottom with the old house foundations and cellar hall. And it was early summer, for I remarked the fatness of the leaves and the grass ahead of the bend of its wings. The kind of day that makes you feel fat and crazy too. Then he went behind a young juniper, straight and slender as a cone. I heard his voice distorted and thick like words spoken under water. Then I was with him, and he was melting and running down over his brain. With my palms, I tried to smooth him upward, back in place, the way you try to smooth wet cement when it runs out cool. But I couldn't. His eyes ran between my fingers. They say a dream is a moment. This one went on and on. The more I tried, the more he melted. When Mary waked me, I was panting with ever. "Spring fever," she said. "That's the first sign." When I was a growing girl, I slept so much my mother sent for Dr. Grady. She thought I had sleeping sickness, but I was only growing in spring. I had a daymare. I would whisk a dream like that on anyone. It's all the confusion. Go up and comb your hair and wash your face. You look tired, dear. Are you all right? It's nearly time to go. You sleep 2 hours. You must have needed it. I wish I knew what's on Mr. Becky's mind. You will, darling. And promise me you will listen to every word. But you might want a word along with you. Businessman don't like ladies listening. Well, he can't have it that way. I won't be there. You know, I have experiences in business. I know, but it's your money he'll be talking about.